My name is Kevin Osby. I am the Stormwater Program Director here at Clayton County Water Authority. Stormwater is essentially just like it sounds. It's really rainwater that falls from the sky during a storm event. Most of this rainwater can soak into the ground through grasses or forests, but in a lot of areas where we have development, we have a lot of more hard surfaces such as roadways, parking lots, sidewalks, homes, buildings. In those cases, water can't soak into the ground. That tends to run off. So essentially, any of that runoff is considered storm water runoff. In most of the cases, if you are in an urban area, it will go to a catch basin. A catch basin is a roadside collection device that catches storm water runoff. From there, it takes the water underneath the ground surface and goes through a series of storm drain lines. Storm drain lines can go along roadways, off the roadways onto private properties, back into ditches that eventually will flow to either a creek, stream, tributary, or a lake, or if you're on the coast, directly to the ocean. You pull behind someone in a car and they take an ashtray and dump it out the side of their window, that's hitting the street. Well, all of that trash will eventually make its way to a catch basin and into our storm drain systems and right on out to our creeks or rivers or lakes. If you have a lot of debris and sediment and trash built up, that water won't be able to flow naturally through the storm drain. It can back up at the roadway or it can back up on someone's property and cause flooding damage. And flooding can cause all kind of other unintended consequences. For instance, if a house is flooded, water can get into that house, it can dampen the floors, it can dampen all the walls and cause mold and mildew and other health problems for that resident.
Well, it is important to keep the storm drains clear of anything that ain't supposed to be in there, because we need water, we drink water, we use water to cook, we use water to take a shower or bath, and you don't want that to get in a storm drain, because what it does, it can pollute the water. And I'm pretty sure when you get home, you know, at the end of the day, you want to turn your water on and drink you some water. So it's always best to keep that storm drain clean so that we can have a clean water. Well, the ways kids can help take care of the environment is not to throw trash outside or to just litter. You know, you can't just throw anything outside. And they can also educate their parents and let them know when you go in the morning, don't take that wrap and just throw it out the window, because it will end up in the storm drain.
Some of the items we found in the storm drain: tires, rims, bicycles, different things from people's homes, trash. It's very important to dispose materials, because the materials could end up on the ground and the rain could push it into a storm drain and eventually could cause the storm drain to back up or flood. Vacuum truck, basically it is a vacuum on wheels, but it's a high pressure vacuum. It's designed to suck up debris, mud, and different objects that we find in storm drains. Also, it has a high pressure water hose on it that helps us to move those debris in position so that we can suck them up. Once we suck up the material or debris in the vac truck, it goes to the tank where we travel to our site, where we have a pit where we dump all the solids that separate from the water, that we're able to scoop them up and take them to a landfill. One of the favorite parts about my job is to be able to see happy customers. Just last week we had a major rain and one customer was flooded pretty bad, and she was so relieved to see us come out and clean the pipe to get the water from her yard.
Oh, what do I love about my job? What do I really love about my job is just helping the community.